Spring now turns to summer. Not only is the harvesting season short, but all sorts of unpredictable events can force the bees to stop. And what's more unpredictable than the weather? All those who can return quickly to the hive. Those who remain face the full force of the rain. The bees are forced to seek shelter from the downpour. Rain poses a real threat. The bees can become so chilled by the water that their muscles no longer function efficiently. They are grounded, unable to fly. Even the guard bees back at the hive are rendered useless, numbed by the cold. It's a good time for the mouse to return without the risk of being stung. A cluster of sodden bees hangs outside the entrance. Too many foragers tried to seek shelter in the hive at the same time. But the mouse still needs to be careful. Once the bees dry out, their reaction will be considerably different. They are not generally known for their hospitality. The bees have reason to be wary. There are enemies everywhere, and of these, one of the most dangerous is the bird ominously known as the bee eater. With a brood of hungry chicks in their nest tunnels, the birds need to meet a constant demand for food. Unfortunately for the bees, the birds are unaffected by the venom in their stings. A single bird can kill 500 bees a day. A whole group can wipe out a colony. The best the bees can do is become an irritation. But the bee eater's thick layer of feathers renders most attacks ineffective. Nearby, the dreaded hornets are also rearing their young. With hungry hornet grubs to feed attacks against the bees increase in intensity. The bees counterattack, but no individual stands a chance against a hornet. The invader quickly disables the bees' flight muscles. The hornets are nightmare neighbors. They'll remain a constant menace to the bee colony for the rest of the summer. Out in the countryside, the work continues. There are thousands of different kinds of bees, but only one kind that produces honey. The honeybee can smell with her antennae. And she can taste with the tip of her proboscis. Not to mention each foot, which can taste what it touches. A forager can visit flowers up to 6 miles away from the hive. For us, that would equal a trip of 800 miles. It's now 16 days since the old queen left the hive. Time for a new queen to emerge from the royal apartments to replace her. The firstborn stakes her claim to be ruler with a piping call. But that's not enough to win the throne. She will also have to fight up to a dozen royal sisters. One possible rival is stung to death through the wall of the brood cell before she can get out. At the same time, another is trying to free herself from her cell. The firstborn queen must now act quickly if she wants to remain in power. She heads for the brood cell of the second rival. As soon as the rival is free, the challenge is taken up. She stakes her own claim with an aggressive call. Thank you.